Hey guys, it's Friday, late afternoon already. It's darker than it looks. The camera makes everything brighter. But yeah, so I haven't filmed anything at all today because I've just been at home trying to get work done, like always. And then when I was getting ready to film, I had a stroke of genius. But one of my assignments, so I had to go do that. Now I'm just gonna get my son from school and get ready for tomorrow, which I said last time that we were thinking about going on a road trip tomorrow, but I still don't know where to. And when I get back home from getting my son, I have to finish the assignment I was working on, because otherwise I'll forget what I wanted to write down and stuff. But time to get the kid. Also, I don't know why I'm out of breath. It's a bad idea to leave the house with wet hair when it's cold out, all right? The never-ending quest for food.
It's like we need to eat every day or something.
I try not to.
Bad habit.
I at least can afford to miss a meal or two or three. But I think we are going for sushi. So
what's
that? Not too bad.
This is how you eat if you're okay with chopsticks. You actually, it's easier to use this. With the strings together with this.
How about some rice?
Huh? Wait. Rice. Ta-da!
You have no teeth to bite.
Bite the aside teeth.
Is it good? A really good meal as always, and I'm surprised at how adventurous the kid was. He ate the chicken katsu, he ate the rice, and I think it was the novelty of the chopsticks.
Mm-hmm.
He had never actually used them before, and I mean they're a kiddie one, so it's not like it takes a whole lot of skill. What you doing?
Mommy.
Come on. So yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot of skill, but for him it was something new, which led into him.
I didn't know people
him.
Shortcut.
Yeah?
That way it was vlogged, I was really
no, close. No. Trying new things. And with that, I'm going to call it a night. I will see you guys tomorrow. Good morning, everyone. I just filmed two introductions to this video today. And the first one, we hadn't actually pressed the right button, or, you know, he hadn't pressed the right button. And the second one, it was a mess. But anyhow, it is Saturday and we are heading to Long Island on a road trip, like I said yesterday. We are going to Living History Museum, I think. And I don't know what else we might do around there, but I think I might have to persuade somebody to stop at the Joann's that's nearby. I haven't been to a Joann's since we moved from Florida in June, so I think he's gonna have to indulge me in that.
Not gonna happen. We don't need any more fabric.
It's not just fabric. But I'm driving for the first time since that Whole Foods trip, and I can't remember how long ago that was.
Months ago now.
So that was this is the second time I've driven since early June. No, since like June 20th or so.
Third time now.
Third?
Yes, because that was the return from...
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, so I'm driving out of the city today because the last time I drove, I actually drove when we came back from the road trip, which was in the afternoon on a Sunday. So I got to drive all in traffic, and that was not fun. And the sun is insane, which there's the shadow of the camera and the screen on my face. But anyhow, Long Island bound road trip. Whoa, whoa, whoa. It was like a 15-minute drive or so. Come on, guys. And this is called the Old Bethpage Village Reconstruction, I think. Come on, let's go explore. So when we came in, the attendant from whom we bought the tickets was talking about an event that's going on today. And I guess it is a recreation of Thanksgiving feast in 1863, I think. But anyhow, she said, oh, it's how they celebrated Thanksgiving back in the day. And I cringed. I am not a snob, but I am a historian, and I am forever spoiled for everybody else. Please, just don't say back in the day. Just don't, okay? Just don't.
Before you know it, you got a nice fire.
Are you actually gonna do a fire right there?
No, no, I'm just gathering the wood out.
No, if we did that, the rest of the house would burn up.
Yeah, we don't have burn.
In here, he's gonna do the fire in here. Let me show you.
Fireplace inside where the bed box is.
Over there.
You see where the locks are?
That's where he's gonna do the fire.
Yeah.
You wanna move here instead?
We need to go to the bathroom. No bathrooms.
This was the bathroom. It's just the door.
Yeah, we just saw the outhouse. You wanna move from an apartment to here?
Wait a second.
In the room where they're playing the violin, I guess it's usually close to the public, so the benches that are there are covered in dust, but I didn't realize it. So I sat down, and when I got up, there was a dust clearing on the bench, like the size of my butt. And so my coat and my my sunscreen, who also sat down, were covered in dust around the bottom. But so far, So far, so good. It's pretty interesting. My son's having fun, which is the big thing. He's finding it fascinating. He's already asking to come back.
I know Newbridge
over by
the train station.
It's not that important.
Are you ready to learn?
Yes.
What do you want to learn?
It's a fun thing. Oh, yeah. They love it. Yeah. We do it about them every year.
The kid is having an absolute blast. He's having such a great time. He's finding every house amazing and interesting and wants to move into them. Of course he doesn't realize the implications of that, but like mother, like son, I guess. You're outnumbered.
Mm-hmm.
Humanities outnumbers the sciences. 2-1.
Livestock like this is walking around.
They're fine. They're pretty domesticated. They're not actually going.
They're just looking for food. I think they're fairly tame. So
I know.
They're used to getting food.
Look, see?
All they're doing is they're following the people because they think they have food.
He's petting them and nothing's happening. It's okay. The turkeys have caused quite the commotion. Hey, Mr. Turkey, that's my bag.
It's got tassels hanging, be careful. Daddy? Come on. Come on.
Alright guys, because they will peck, so...
This one is obsessed with
okay,
me.
Okay, no one's following me. No one's following me when I even have food. No one's even following me when I even have food.
Tenders.
It's true.
Turkey itis!
I love that! I can stay with these things all day!
Why have they escaped?
They haven't escaped. They weren't penned in. They just live here.
So that is what happens when Thanksgiving is coming up and they sense that you're gonna eat them. Whoosh. And then you trip on rocks over there. Diner in plain view in Long Island, and we're having lunch, and he just ordered a chili burger, and he is going to try to actually put it in his mouth. Let's see how that's gonna work out for him.
It's a small burger.
Oh gosh. Is that a mouth or a garbage disposal? Is it good? I'm having French dip sandwich. This is the dip over there. And Monkey is having pancakes as always.
What's the matter, Jane?
It's sandy.
Well done, it's a beach. And this surprises you?
I thought it would be like compacted.
Why? It's a beach.
Because
how
is it in Florida?
Yeah, this isn't Florida, this is New York.
We are in a place called Overlook Beach, and it's pretty deserted, but the sun is just going back behind the cloud now, but it's so beautiful. Emmy, I'm gonna do a spin. So that's the beach back there. Let's do a spin. Can you see the sun? Let's see. Just stunning. And when the sun was out from behind the cloud, those dunes over there that you can't see, but I will show you, were lit up just beautifully. Such a beautiful place. Watch the things for yourself, because me telling you about them is not fun. It's good to see things, and this is like I was not expecting it to be this weird, to be honest. Sunset over there. So after what, 6 months that we've been here now, I am finally gonna go to a Joann's again, and I know that the stuff that they sell is not great quality. Hey guys, wait for me. But it's just the principle. You hear the angels?
Are we gonna use a shopping cart?
Heck no.
Ah, so now it is 10 o'clock at night and we are exhausted. We've been home for a couple of hours. But yeah, that was a great day. We all had fun. The kid particularly had fun. The turkeys were a hoot. And yeah, so I'm glad we did that. And on that note, I'm going to sign out for the night. I will see you guys tomorrow morning. Good morning, everyone. It is Sunday morning and I am on my way. Oops. Something in my bag's making a noise. And I'm on my way to the library to get some work done. Because I only have one class next week, but I do actually have to do quite a bit of work for it. And after yesterday's escapades to Long Island, I am very behind. So I just got breakfast from my favorite deli in the village. It's right in the corner over there. I was thinking, before I moved to New York, I rarely ever carry cash because everywhere you could pay with a credit card. But here, there are so many places that don't take it, that are cash only, that you kind of sort of have to carry at least $5 if you want to buy things, you know, like drinks. So it's so strange to me that in such a big city, such an advanced and urbanized city, there are so many places that are still cash only, and this includes restaurants. This is not just like little corner shops. So yeah, I'm coming up to Washington Square Park and going to the library. I'll check in with you guys later. Well, that was an exercise in futility. When I go to the library, I usually go to the graduate student study area, and it's usually pretty quiet until about 11 o'clock or so, in which case it gets really loud. And today there was a particularly loud group, which meant that I might as well be studying in a subway station. So I decided that that was just not productive and it was a waste of my time, because I was so distracted. I was reading words, but I couldn't comprehend what I was reading, and it's quieter at home. So I left. I got some bubble tea, and yes, I am totally using my scarf to hold my cold bubble tea. And I'm gonna go to B&H photo, yay! And then I'm gonna head home and do the rest of my work from there. So I came to B&H looking for a light setup, a cheap one and smallish one that I can use instead of my windows, because when I've, when I've been doing sit down videos, I've mostly just been sitting in front of a window, but now it's just so gloomy out because it's winter. And I usually film in the afternoons, and by the time that, you know, 4 o'clock, 4:30 comes around, it's already too dark to do that. So if I want to film anything from now until summer again, I'm gonna need some lights. But I wasn't sure what I was looking for, so I talked to one of the guys and he suggested something, but then my husband had other things in mind, so I didn't get the lights. Then I thought, I'm gonna get a replacement battery for the new vlogging camera, and they didn't have that either. And so then I thought, I'm gonna check out some lavalier microphones, because I've been using one with little success to film, well, actually to capture some of the audio for some of the videos, and that didn't work out either. So I left B&H empty-handed, which is not a usual thing for me. And now I'm gonna go home, but instead of taking the A and then having to switch to another line, I'm just gonna walk about half a mile to Hurdle Square and take the F from there and head home, and I'll check in with you guys later. My battery died on the way home, and I couldn't film anything after, I think it was 8th Avenue, so just before Macy's, might have been 7th Avenue, I can't remember, but anyhow, so the camera died, and I couldn't film. Before I actually got on the train, I stopped at Macy's to take pictures of their Christmas display, which is out already. I stopped at Sephora, and that was dangerous. There I got some mineral foundation. I got some Too Faced Melted Kisses. I got, I'd never heard of this brand, but I guess it's called Bite, and they are lip crayons. I really like the color, so I picked that up. I picked this bag up. It's just a little makeup bag. And because I wasn't in town for my birthday, I was in town, but I didn't go into the store for my birthday, and so they couldn't give me my birthday gift then. They gave it to me today, and it's this NARS little kit, and it has, I think, a couple of lip pencils and one eyeliner. So that's what I did. And I'm home, and the sunset is beautiful, and there's all kinds of Christmas lights out there now. Basically, Christmas has come to town. And with that, I'm going to call it a night, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this vlog. I had so much fun in the last 3 days, and yeah, this vlog is probably a little longer than I usually go for. I haven't edited it yet, obviously, so I'm not sure how long it's gonna be, but I think it's worth it because there's so many great things from yesterday that I want to show you guys. And as always, thank you for watching. If you have made it this far, you're a star, and I will see you next time. Bye.